Prince and the Pig. The Prince and the Pig is an interesting story. Our great pig prince is delighted to find a true princess, and the pig is the best. Indeed, let's look at how this story should have ended, shall we?
Oh, mother! I fear I shall never find a true princess that is truly true, and now it's beginning to rain. Woe is me!
Don't despair, my darling dear. You deserve a princess, as true as can be.
And then, the pretty princess was at his whiniest, and storm has reached its torments. There came a knock at the castle from the door. The prince opened the door and find the stockiest, muddiest, least princess aced looking woman he had ever seen.
Hello.
Yes.
I got separated from the trembling complexion during this terrible storm. May I please come in out of the rain?
I'm sorry, but we only allowing entrance to true princesses. Good day.
But the woman at the door would go give up. That not even would this time.
Yes.
I am a true princess. Please let me come in out of the rain.
The prince was confused. Could this soggy, muddy, now grumpy young woman surely be a true princess?
Of course, you can come in muddy, my dear.
Oh, thank you. I'm so tired, drenched and hungry. I've barely slept all on this trip. What I really need is shelter for the night.
But mother, she is...
Of course. Why didn't you get something to eat and warm up by the fire as we prepare a nice room for you sleeping tonight?
Thank you so much.
But mother, why would you...
Don't worry, darling. I have a perfect way to test if she is a true princess or not.
Somewhere, the stubby princess dragged out the queen, dispatched and servants to prepare a bed with 20 mattresses.
More!
Then she added 20 soft down mattresses.
More!
Then the queen took a single tiny green pea and placed it in another massive pile of commanders and mattresses.
More? No, a true princess is sensitive, so if she feels that tiny pea on the roll of them, then we will know she's a true princess.
But why don't we just call the kingdom? She says she's from and ask them if she real princess.
This is the only way.
Next morning at the breakfast, the princess and the queen anxiously awaited the arrival of the princess. Finally, she dragged herself down the stairs with what the princess thought were every muslin dance under her red slow's eyes.
Good morning, my dear.
How did you sleep last night?
Sadly, I didn't sleep well at all. Thank you for the room, but there was some sort of frog or lump in those mattresses. No matter how I tossed or turned, it couldn't get comfortable. I never actually fell asleep.
Hooray! Haha, you passed the test!
What?
That was all a test. Only true princes would be sensitive enough you know? The bee was there. You passed it. Now we know you are true princess.
Wow, wow, wow.
I showed her.
I showed it on our doorstep. Drench it from full tea and accept and
exhausted.
And you decided to test me?
Yes, it was all a test, but you passed, so hooray!
And now you two get married!
Yes, married! Hooray! Ha!
No, we're not getting married. What is wrong with you people? That's the meanest thing anyone has ever done to me. Why would I want to marry someone who treats women that way?
Because I'm a prince.
What you said to me last night? Oh, right, I remember. Good day!
But wait, you're the only true princess in the land.
Yeah, but you're not the only prince. I'm to find someone nicer.
Oh, and she wants someone nicer. A kind of prince who respected her and didn't try to put her through silly stupid tests. Then they live happiness when after them never ate beans. So, she moral of the story. Always be nice to people and don't hide your vegetables anywhere.
The end.